There was pressure from the opposition activists after a letter Njoki wrote to his Democratic Party on the decision to take up a job at the Uganda Human Rights Commission went public. The joint opposition candidate for the Busia LCV election had written to DP, informing the party that if approved by Parliament, he would, as a citizen, consider serving the country as a member of the Uganda Human Rights Commission. His announcement was greeted with frustrations from members of the opposition. Hours after Njoki confirmed he would take up Museveni's job, he announced his U-turn during a press conference held at the DP offices in Kampala today.
To consider, after consideration, to accept that offer, even if I were to be invited by Parliament. I haven't been invited by Parliament yet, but I am already saying, no, I will not take up the offer. I now have to choose between taking up that appointment or serving the people of Busia.
In his change of mind, Njoki questioned the timing of the appointment.
The timing of the appointment is problematic. Having been nominated on the 6th and the nominations ended on the 7th, where political parties on the opposition entrusted me to be the sole candidate, even though that had other candidates, potential candidates, were asked to step down. There was no chance left by the time that appointment was made that political parties could nominate alternative candidates.
Why doesn't he groom his people to be as good as we are so that they serve him? We shall not allow it.
The DP President General Norbert Mao said Njoki's appointment was a bait and advised Njoki to reject President Museveni's job offer. He promised total support from all the opposition parties.
Because if the scheme had succeeded, the level of mistrust within the opposition camp would escalate. I have talked to all my leaders, colleagues at the highest level, the president of FDC, Patrick Amuriat. I've spoken to General Mugisha Muntu. I've spoken to Asuman Basalirwa, president of JEMA. Spoken to my younger brother, Chadondo East MP, Robert Chagulanyi. I've spoken to Colonel Kiza Besigye. We are all heading to Busia. This was an attempt by Yoweri Museveni to force us to score an own goal.
What Njoki's U-turn means is that the race to replace Stephen Wanyama Ouma Adeya is on. The Court of Appeal threw Adeya out of office over his 2013 conviction over corruption. In the 2016 election, Njoki had polled 21,844 to lose to Adeya, who got 31,443 votes. The race is expected to be stiff between Njoki and Paul Boniface Ogutu of the ruling National Resistance Movement. Report by Dias Walugembe for Urban TV.